Sunday, y'all. Boy, been going hard this weekend. I've been getting my Uber on since Thursday. Every day. 4 days in a row. I rarely do that. But, got a special occasion coming up next week, which will be the wife's birthday. So, gotta make sure my pockets is padded the right way. But, still gonna be a humble thing. You know, we doing this thing, man. No credit cards, man. So, everything that is gonna be purchased for this birthday is gonna be done with cash, man. Out to eat, gifts and everything. So we ain't breaking our necks for all this stuff, man. We got a goal in mind, you feel me? On my way to this little birthday party, shout out to Kason, turning 2 years old. Shout out to Tony and Christy too. Hey, listen, man. Last night was crazy as hell. Yo, man. I got a ping to pick this lady up. So the lady comes out. They were at over in Virginia Highlands. You know where all the little restaurants are still over there, hand in hand, neighbors and all that stuff. So they come out as a guy and a girl, and the girl hops in the front seat, and the guy gets in the back. He's like, "Why you didn't get in the back with me?" she's like, "Just get in the car, whatever." So he got in the car. So when they got in, I was playing old school station, old school hip hop station, 97.9, OG 97.9. So Mystical. Shake your fans, show me what you're working with. That was playing, right? This is a white couple, right? So the girl starts she over there start dancing like a stripper in the front seat. Like, man, she's whipping her hair and bending over, like popping it on the seat. And Joe's in the back, I'm looking like, hey man, I'm trying not to look like dude's sitting right there. And I'm like, what the hell is going on? You know what I'm saying? So she dancing, twerking and popping it all on the seat and stuff. I'm like, what the hell is going on? Whipping her hair all over the place. So dude, she reached back and touched him, he touched her, he grabbing, they pulling on each other. She's like, what the hell is going on? So he's like, hey buddy, can you stop us to get some beer? So he's like, what time they stop selling beer here? I said, 12 o'clock. He was like, it was like 11:45. So y'all know, for the people who've been watching, I was thinking about that white privilege video, that stuff that happened. So I said, I gotta see if this is gonna happen again. So he's like, well, whatever the first gas station you see, I need you to pull over there. I'm like, all right, man. So I'm driving, the girl's still over here dancing and shit. Girl reached over here and kissed me on my cheek. I'm like, man, what the hell going on? So dude was in the pain, he ain't say nothing. I was like, man, what the hell? So she was like, after she kissed me on my cheek, she's like, I love my boyfriend. I love my boyfriend. He won't give me a baby. Tell him to give me a baby. I was like, what the hell? I said, hey man, your girl said give her a baby. So they were talking back and forth and shit. I don't know what the hell was going on. But so we pulled up to the gas station. And so I'm pulling up and I'm turning, right? And he was like, all right, I'm going to get it. She's like, no, I'm going to get it. He said, no, babe, you've been paying for stuff all night. And she was like, I'll get it. She's like, I got more money than you ever have. I was like, god damn. I said, man, I can't have no chick like that, man. You can't be talking like that. You don't talk to your man like that. I got more money than you ever have. Damn. So I'm pulling up in the store. I ain't even stopped the car. I'm pulling in the parking space. She done opened the door and hopped out like damn Dukes of Hazzard up. Something like the Matrix or something. I jumped out and started walking. The door swung open. I'm like, what the hell's wrong with this chick? went in. I'm like, I'm gonna see if she gonna get this bill. so she went in. To where the bill was, I was watching the cashier to see what he was going to do. So he watched him go over there, and as soon as they opened the door, he threw his hands out, like, what the hell are they doing? So they couldn't get the bills, and she walked up to the front, and they wouldn't let him get it. The guy went in, went in there with him. And so we went to, going closer to them, to wherever they were staying or whatever, where she stayed, whatever. And he was like, let's try another one when we get closer to where you are. Because I told him about, you know, that situation that happened with, I seen people buy beer at 1 a.m. So we get closer to the place, and man, they back there, they start making out in the back seat right there, back there kissing and pulling out on each other and making all these damn noises and shit. So next thing you know, you just hear pow. She just slapped the hell out of the dude. Pow, pow. He's like, hey, why you smacking me? Why you smacking me? Like, man, what the hell is going on? This chick is crazy, yo. She back there slapping the hell out of this dude, right? So he's asking, why you slapping me? So she's just mumbling stuff. I couldn't understand what the hell she was saying. But so we get closer to about where they're going. Stop at another gas station. He's like, yeah, let's try this one. Pull out of that one. They hop out, went in there together. Well, no, he went in there by himself this time. She was just sitting in the back. And again, he didn't get the beer. I was happy that he didn't get the beer, because I didn't want that. I didn't want that, my theory, to be true. But hey, man. So they didn't get it, and we got there. I was taking them home, and he said, all right, man, just take us where we're going. So we talked to them to where they was going, and so we got there, and the girl was like, I don't want you to come in. I don't want you to come in. I don't want you in my house. I want you to go home. He's like, no, you want me to come in. So they got out, whatever they was arguing with. I was like, what the hell? How you go from twerking and making out the back seat, and now you want to send the dude home? Oh, no, you going to do something. You did all that. You know what I mean? You should be ready to go. What the hell going on? I don't know what that was all about, man. That was crazy. The girl was damn twerking on the damn seat. She said, what the hell? I'm sitting there trying not to look at the girl, man. What the fuck? Whatever, man. Hey. As a man, he should have been the one that said something. He told her, hey, man, chill out. I just laughed. Shook my head. That be that, man. That's the crazy stuff that happens when you out here driving for Uber, man. You never know what's gonna happen. You have a quiet week, nothing going on, then one night everything jumping crazy. But hey, man, that's it. So rain this Sunday in Georgia, cool. Fall came in real quick on us. Had to break out the long sleeves on them, man. It's cold out here, man. Get back to my cigar, head to this birthday party, stop by the package store, give me some tequila, so I can be sipping on some brown while I'm at this party. Today, it's the CAO Cameroon Good Mile Cigar. For all you guys who want to try to start out smoking cigars, this is a good cigar to start. We got a little pepper to it, but just mild enough, you know. Got a little pepper, like, you know, a little white pepper. Good stuff, man. But get back to my Erykah Badu. On Sunday, when I'm riding, I like to play my little cool out music, man. Be trapping and all that hip hop, bebop, all them other days. But Sunday, I cool out. Yeah.